At 34 years old and the mother of two children younger than three, Stephanie Dobson had gotten used to having some unusual stomach and gastrointestinal symptoms.
It's easy to chalk up a lot of symptoms to pregnancy.
But when the symptoms didn't go away after the birth of her second child, her primary care doctor urged her to see a specialist.
And ended up getting a colonoscopy and was diagnosed with stage 3B rectal cancer during my last week of maternity leave.
The diagnosis was a shock. No one in her family had had colorectal cancer. She came to Dana-Farber Cancer Institute, where she was told she was one of the rare patients with rectal cancer with a genetic abnormality called MSI high status, which made her a candidate for immunotherapy. She was also told this genetic abnormality might be due to a genetic syndrome called Lynch syndrome.
We think that about 1 in 300 people in the U.S. have Lynch syndrome. And so what that means is that about 1 in 300 people out there have an inherited genetic phenomenon that is putting them at risk for a variety of cancers.
Cancers include colon, rectal, uterine, ovarian, and cancers of the urinary tract. Not everyone with Lynch will develop cancer, but the risk is greater, anywhere from 20 to 80%. Stephanie's Lynch test came back positive.
That news was harder for me than the cancer diagnosis, mostly because I have two small children.
Meaning they may be carriers of the same gene associated with Lynch syndrome that Stephanie has. Stephanie says her family is looking at this information as a tool to help them make better decisions about their own cancer risk and when they should consider screening. As for her immunotherapy treatments, she says they're going great and have allowed her to avoid chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery.
It's working. My tumor is shrinking really quickly, which is really exciting. Great news.